Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to Amazed by the Quran, a series in which I love talking about what I find amazing about the Quran. Today I want to share with you two ayat. I'm going to compare them to each other. One belongs to the 57th surah, Surah Al-Hadid, and the other to the 64th surah, At-Taghabun. Both of them are very similar in their subject matter, so I'll read through them first. Ma asaba min musibatin fil ardi wa la fi anfusikum illa fi kitabin min qabli an nabra'aha inna dhalika 'ala Allahi yaseer. There is not a single calamity of any kind that ever strikes you in the earth nor inside of yourselves, except that it is in a book that we have already declared it in. That is certainly easy for Allah to do. That's hadid. No calamity will strike you in the earth nor deep inside yourself, except that it's already been written down. And Allah, it's easy for Allah. The second case is taghabun. Allah says, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. There's not a single calamity of any kind that will ever strike you except by Allah's permission, by Allah's leave. And whoever were to believe in Allah, Allah will guide their heart. And Allah is all knowledgeable about everything. So it's interesting that in the first case, when Allah says, not a single calamity will strike you, He added, not in the land and not deep inside yourselves. Not in the earth and not inside yourselves. He didn't do that for the case of taghabun. In taghabun he said, not any calamity at all will strike, except that it is by Allah's permission. So he didn't add that additional qualifier of in the land and inside of yourselves. This is part of the beauty of the Qur'an in its sensitivity to context. Surah Al-Hadid, which is the one actually I want to talk to you about more. By the way, Surah Al-Taghabun, 64th surah, where Allah did not add fil ardi wa la fi anfusikum, not in the land, not inside yourselves. He didn't add that piece, is actually more brief in its account of faith. Surah Al-Hadid is much more expansive. And the previous ayat, listen to this, اِعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا لَعِبٌ وَلَهْوٌ وَزِينَةٌ وَتَفَاخُرٌ بَيْنَكُمْ. You had better know that worldly life amounts to nothing more than games and entertainment and beautification and showing off to one another. وَتَكَاثُرٌ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ, and sharing this desire to have more and more when it comes to money and kids. كَمَثَلِ غَيْثٍ عَجَبَ الْكُفَّارَ نَبَاتُهُ, like perfect rain that the farmer who planted the seed is impressed with. ثُمَّ يَهِيجُ, then it matures. فَتَرَاهُ مُصْفَرًا, and you'll see it turn yellow. ثُمَّ يَكُونُ حُطَامًا, then it'll turn into crust, it'll be completely destroyed. This entire parable, and then after that, not a single calamity will strike you in the earth nor inside of yourselves. Now appreciate the beauty of that. Allah talked about what you like inside yourselves, which is what? Games, entertainment, beautification, showing off to each other, getting more and more in terms of money, isn't it? Stuff you have inside yourselves. And then you were compared to the earth. To the earth. Like a seed that's planted in the earth and rain comes and it comes out. And that elaborate picture that's being painted, part of the ayah is about the earth. And part of the ayah is about yourself. How reflection on the earth is going to make you think about yourself. In the very next ayat, he says, not a single calamity will strike you in the earth and not inside yourselves, except that Allah has decreed it. SubhanAllah. Like how beautifully the expressions are captured in the Quran and how they flow. You know, something is triggered in your mind, you're thinking about it, and Allah recaptures it in your mind just from these little expressions. This was the place to say it. There is no parable, there's no analogy in Surah At-Taghabun. There's no discussion about what's going on deep inside of yourselves. That's not the conversation there. So he didn't mention it, SubhanAllah. May Allah Azza wa Jal again help us appreciate the beauty, the perfection, the majesty of this divine word. And may Allah Azza wa Jal enlighten our hearts and our very beings with it. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.